Hello, my name is Chris Timer. I'm a career program advisor here at Valencia College on West Campus for students seeking AS degrees in business. Today I'm going to show you the Look Ahead feature in My Education Plan. So the Look Ahead is a great feature for a student who wants to plan future term courses, possibly looking at how that'll fit into their education plan and seeing if those will meet specific requirements for their degree. So I will start with the Look Ahead here. Charlie Ellis is our student. And Charlie wants to take a few courses in the fall semester, and he's going to see how that fits into his AA General Studies degree. So right here we have the subject box and course number, and so I'm going to start off by testing out statistics. Charlie wants to take statistics in the fall, so I'm going to go ahead and add that course. Over here on the right-hand side, you'll see the box where the courses we are adding. Should I make a mistake here, I can always just go ahead and choose that course and remove it. But I want to go ahead and add statistics. And Charlie's going to also take U.S. government as well. So I've added two courses here, statistics and U.S. government. So I'm going to go back up here and process new. And a new worksheet's going to populate here for Charlie. So we're going to scroll down. All right, so our first course was statistics. We can see right here in the Gordon Rule math section, statistics will meet Charlie's math requirement, at least 3 credits of those. And then we'll drop down a little further, and he can also see that U.S. government will fit nicely into his plan. So that's a way to go ahead and look forward. If Charlie wants to take additional courses, he could always go back and add additional courses to that as well. And so Charlie also has another option. He might be undecided with his AA degree at this point. And so he is thinking about taking an AS business degree. So he wants to determine whether his courses next semester, statistics and U.S. government, will meet those requirements for his AS business degree. So I'm gonna go to what if. I've just chosen the what if analysis. So Charlie needs to pick his catalog here. He might be changing his major, of course, so he's gonna go into the 14-15 catalog. And Charlie's gonna pick a AS degree in business administration. So he wants to do, let's just say Charlie wants to do small business management. All right, so Charlie has chosen small business management. You'll see that here in the right-hand side. His catalog year is 2014-2015. And now I can choose future classes for that particular degree. So Charlie wants to take statistics. So I'm going to go ahead and add that course, and you'll see it again over here on the right-hand side. And Charlie also wants to take U.S. government. I'm going to go ahead and add that right over here on the right-hand side. So statistics and U.S. government. We know that Charlie wants to do a what-if analysis for his small business administration. And then we got 2014-2015. So let's go ahead and process the what-if. All right, so a new worksheet pops up for Charlie, and this is based on the AS degree. Okay, it already has some courses that Charlie's already taken, but we're going to scroll down here. And Charlie's going to notice that statistics will take care of his science or math requirement. So that would be a good course to choose if he would like to meet that requirement. And then Charlie has a general elective for his degree. So U.S. government would fit in as his general elective. And he'll see that courses are in progress. Now, Charlie may not necessarily want to take U.S. government as his elective. So we would certainly encourage Charlie to meet with an advisor. But he can see how, if he did take that class, it would fit into his plan. So we've done the what-if analysis as far as looking ahead and seeing what courses Charlie can take to meet a future degree. And we've also done the look-ahead option as well.